Welcome back to Let's Play Song of the Ocean, Legend of Heroes, Stuff, Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. This is the embassy in Enverin. I think it's the embassy. Or the castle. This is Castle Enverin, the residence of the Duke. What is your business here? Forte says, we were referred by Viscount Ugul. McBain says, we would like to see the Duke of Pensola. McBain handed over the Viscount's letter. Let me see. The gatekeeper read the Viscount's letter. Hey! That's not for your eyes, mister. It's a very courteous letter of reference. I understand the purpose of your request for an audience with the Duke. Una says, we also have a personal letter from the Viscount to the Duke. Please let us see the Duke. I knew you came all this way, but it's unfortunate. The Duke is presently out of the castle. I believe he will be back soon, so please come back a little later. What can we do? He's not in. McBain says, let's come back later. Well, that's crappy. A man's voice says, people of Enverin, may I have your attention, please? Could that be the Duke? A woman's voice says, hello, people of Enverin. Oh, it's Rachel and Shao, I bet. Says Forte. Those voices, McBain says. Una says, they sound familiar. As well they should. Because there they are. Shao says, please come and see. And also listen, says Rachel. Shao says, amusing entertainment will begin. A fantastic concert will start, says Rachel. Everyone, please feel free, Shao says. Experience the event you can talk to your friends about. Canuck says, are they troubadours? Grandpa Raparo says, it sounds interesting. Forte says, it's Shao and Rachel. Altos asks, do you know them? Una says, they helped us in Graysel. Shao is an old friend of Grandpa Max. Altos says, then I should go and greet them. No, wait, says McBain. Let's see how things go. Shao says, hello, everyone. We are giving you a special deal today. You can enjoy our wonderful performance absolutely free of charge. Rachel says, that's because this is a promotional concert. Canuck asks, promotional concert? Are you sponsored by a store or something? Rachel says, you're a smart one. That's correct. Well, thanks. Canuck blushes. Shao says, hey, you, the girl over there. Me? Says Shenka. Yes, you, pretty girl. What is it? What's your favorite food? Well, let me see. What's your favorite food? What's your favorite food? What food do you like? Meat, vegetables, fish, and fruit. You're growing up, so you must be eating everything. Can you make up your mind? She's pushy. Well, I like everything. Really? You have nothing you can't eat? Good girl. Rachel says, you must eat everything. Look at this guy. He loves to drink and kept drinking. That's why he's so fat now. Hey, hey, says Shao. But don't you have something you eat every day? Here's a question, Shao says. Rachel says, you eat it at breakfast. You eat it at lunch. You also eat it at dinner. Well, what is it? Eat it at breakfast. This is a riddle? Breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Food? What would that be? Says Shenka. Shao says, what is it? What is it? What is it? It's fluffy and soft, says Rachel. It's baked golden brown. Oh, bread. Well, they know she has bread for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Ding! Light bulb. It's bread! Bingo, says Shao. You answered correctly. Forte whispering, "Where's the musical performance?" Luna says, "But which bakery are they promoting?" Altos says, "Could it be Uncle Edgar's bakery?" "Where can you find a lot of tasty bread?" Shao says. "There's one place you go for your bread. It's Edgar's bakery." Rachel says, "Please come to Edgar's bakery." Parade of clowns. That doesn't sound too good. Is she playing an instrument or is she whistling? I'm not sure. "What's that? Their musical performance is really ordinary." "Oops," says Shao. Canuck says, "The singing was great." "Oh, that was singing?" "Thanks," says Rachel. Grandma Daria says, "The talk was funny." Rig says, "Goodbye." And the other two don't say anything. Shao says, "What a bummer." Shenka says, "Mister, cheer up." "Girl, thank you. Thank you," says Shao. McBain says, "He's so miserable. I can't watch him anymore." McBain, says Shao. "Hey, you," says Rachel. Forte says, "Hello." Jan says, "Woof." And Rick says, "Creak." Rachel says, "Is that the desert rat we saw the other day?" Okay, why are Una and Forte not coming up? Oh, I guess they are there, but we're in the form of McBain right now. "His name is Rick," says Una. "So you carry him around with you. Hey, who's that cute little boy you have? I haven't seen him before." Altos says, "Cute? Me? Nice to meet you. I'm Altos." Forte says, "We met him in Bozerl. He won the first prize at the recital in Pinzel." Shao says, "Really? This young man won at the recital?" "Hello," says Rachel. "I must thank you," says Altos. "I think it's Uncle Edgar who asked you to promote his store." Rachel says, "That means you're a family of the baker?" "Something like that." "Enough greeting," says McBain. "By the way, what was that performance you just gave? Your first-class troubadours." "Oh, it was good? That's supposed to be good? It sounded horrible. I thought they were, like, messing up." "Aside from everything else, I do admit that you're a great accordionist." There's, like, no rhythm at all. It's just chaos with the two instruments. Or her singing, whatever. "But that performance was a school play." "You really have good ears, Master," says Shao. Rachel says, "Something is in my father's head and he can't concentrate. You know about the audition to be held at the party in Ryotam Island, right? My father badly wants to enter the audition. But you must be nominated by one of the party guests to enter. We can't find anyone who is willing to nominate us." Shao says, "Man, my luck ran out." McBain says, "Tut, you can't concentrate because of such a trivial matter." "But the party is hosted by wealthy merchant Rish. He must pay good money." "If you win, you'll get loads of money." "That was a dumb question," says McBain. Forte says, "You talk really well though, Shao." Rachel says, "That's because he's always like that. He wasn't thinking." "Oh, I see." "She's right," says Una. Shao says, "Are you making fun of me or what?" McBain says, "It has been your weakness. Whenever something happens and it's in your head, you can't concentrate. What it means is that you need more mental training." "Whatever you say, Master." Una says, "So it's not easy to enter the audition, huh?" "I didn't know. We got a nomination from Ambassador Gareno so easily." Shao is speechless. "Oops," says Forte. "She shouldn't have said that." Shao chuckles. "What's wrong with him?" says Forte. "He's about to have a nervous breakdown or something." "I heard you," says Shao. Oh! McBain! So that's it. Now I know, you sly old fox. You went behind our backs and got yourselves nominated. Hey, we didn't even know you wanted to enter the audition. What? McBain says, well, we should probably get going. It's time the Duke had returned. Yeah, that's right, says Forte. Una says, yes, we should leave. Alto says, excuse us. Like the stage left. Where are you going, Master? So long, says McBain. Oh, we're running. Is Shao following us? Says McBain. Una says, it's my mistake. I shouldn't have said that. I'm sorry. Don't worry, Una. But Shao is Shao. He's always obsessed with money. Alto says, we really should be heading for the castle. The Duke of Pensola may be back already. It's only been like 8 minutes. Oh, yes, says McBain. I guess we lost them. I wonder if people say other things differently, though. Now that the performance... Let's go see over here. Same thing. That guy with the accordion, he did make mistakes, but the sound was beautiful. Hehehe, that lady was sexy. She said I was smart. Hehehe. No, she's a poor judge of character. Anything. Who else was there? There was an old lady there. Oh, that's right. We can talk to him about his promotion. I thought you were going to the castle. Oh, we can't say anything to about it. These two watched, right? Yeah, they left without saying a word while the blonde turned back. My child has been happy ever since the performance. She must have really liked it. Why don't you ask her if she liked it? She's right there. The fat man was very funny. He didn't play well, but I'd love to see him again. The fat man was awesome. Awesome, huh? Now where's that old lady? I think she was the only one else there watching the performance. That's the end of that side. Struggling to earn your living. Oh, there she is. The quality of troubadours is not good these days. Their skills aren't that bad, but they don't perform seriously. I hope you're different from those performers. McBain says, you're so harsh on our fellow artists. If you knew those artists, you should caution them. I'm so sorry. Why are you apologizing? Why, I asked you. Oh, Rig, yeah. The fat man was really bad. Are you bad, too? I hope not, says Forte. He's rude, says Una. Then play some for us. I want to listen to you perform. Oh, yeah, it's good to want things you can't have. You weren't watching the performance, were you? Yeah, same thing. Alright, let's go back to the castle. Not embassy. It is a castle. Una asks, is the Duke back yet? Oh, you again. Unfortunately, not yet. Hey, I think the Duke is back now. Head guard says, the Duke has returned. Move away. Please? The Duke of Pensola. I'm so busy. Oh, sorry about the mouse pointer. I just returned, and soon I must leave for Riatam Island. Attendant says, every day is packed with official duties. You must be exhausted, Your Highness. Yes, I am, but everything is for the country. Who are you? They are requesting an audience with Your Highness, says the gatekeeper. They claim they have a reference letter and a personal letter from Viscount Eagle. What do you mean we claim we have a reference letter? You read the reference letter. A letter from Eagle? Says the Duke. I'm not interested. I don't even want to open it. It's full of reprovals, as always. You read the letter and report the content to me later. The attendant says, yes, Your Highness. McBain says, that's not enough. What? Says the Duke. I said that's not enough. I was asked by Viscount Eagle to give you this letter. I can't just give it to you knowing that you won't read it. I can't complete my mission until the message from the Viscount has been duly conveyed. Forte says, Grandpa, we shouldn't anger the Duke. Who do you think you are? You're out of line, says the Duke. As you can see, I'm just an old troubadour. I don't have a noble name that might be of your interest. Well, so you perform. We can give you a performance that will wash away any misguided beliefs. The Duke chuckles. Haha, that's funny. Wash away misguided beliefs? Performance is just performance. Don't try to make a mountain out of a hill. The attendant says, Duke, perhaps you should listen. We haven't found the performers you're supposed to nominate for the audition. I'm not interested in street performers. It's just an old man and kids. How can they possibly be good? They even have a dog with them. It's laughable. Excuse me, says McBain. Eagle is my childhood friend, says the Duke. I know what's in his mind. I don't have to read his letter. Get rid of them. Yes, Your Highness, says the gatekeeper. Please go away, as he said. Please. Oh, that's a fine how do you do. The gatekeeper says, things got a little complicated. Yeah, we noticed. Anyway, unless the Duke changes his mind, the reference from the Viscount won't do you any good. I'm sorry, but you must leave. It's your fault, Grandpa. We couldn't give him the letter because he got angry at you. Viscount Eagle even wrote a letter of reference for us. Una says, still, the Duke is too much, don't you think, Forte? Oh, crap. I missed it. Whatever he said, you guys can, pause the video really quick. Hopefully you'll catch it. He also wanted us to awaken the Duke to his senses. As long as we accepted this mission, it doesn't matter if he is a king. I'll talk to him until he comes to his senses. He's so stubborn, says Forte. Of course I am. Alto says, let's go to Uncle Edgar's first. After a good rest, we may come with a good idea. Okay, we should go to the bakery then, says Forte. Well, that is Edgar's. Please come back when the Duke is in a good mood, will you? Guess we have no choice. Now, we could go right to Edgar's, but let's see if there's any new things to be said. I'll just check in this one place. If it's all the same, we'll go on to Edgar's. Thank you. Okay. Alright, we're gonna move on to Edgar's. Get out of my way, Wall. Alto says, I'm back. How was it? Were you able to see the Duke? In fact, Alto's explained to Edgar about their encounter with the Duke of Pensola. I see. The Duke of Pensola behaved like that. Alto says, I didn't know he was such a person. Edgar says, as a matter of fact, ever since he befriended Rish, the Duke's reputation has plummeted. I had to close my store because I had no flour to bake my bread with. They said that they needed more flour for the party being thrown by Rish and took all that I had in my store. That's absurd, says Altos. Una says, that's why you asked Shao and Rachel to give you a promotional performance. Oh, so you know Shao and Rachel? I wanted to make up for the inconvenience I caused my customers. Altos says, you've had a pretty tough time, Uncle. I'm glad I came to help. McBain says, Forte, Una? Yes, says Forte. What is it? Una says. I'm going back to see Viscount Eagle once again. All the way to Dogarna? Says Forte. Now that the Duke of Pensola refused to receive the letter, we must return it to Viscount Eagle. Now we got a wall on the way back. Just warp us back there. Alto says, then I'll come with you. I'll help you when I come back. Will you be all right by yourself for a while? Of course, Edgar says. You go help them. McBain says, no. We appreciate your offer, but we don't need your help this time. We're just returning the letter. Right, says Forte. The hideous monster in the cave is gone now. If you say so, says Altos. All right, when you come back, delicious bread will be waiting for you. Edgar says, okay, let's prepare the dough. Yes, says Altos. Forte says, this bakery had to shut down because of the Duke of Pensola. Una says, I guess the Duke of Pensola has become a very different person from whom Viscount Eagle used to know. McBain says, perhaps we should find out what Viscount Eagle really wants. When you come back from Dogarna, please drop by. The monster in the cave was exterminated, but the road to Dogarna is still dangerous. Please take care of yourselves. Alright, so we're gonna head all the way back. Because they did not warp us back. I don't have anything additional to say. Well, if we talk to the guard again, tell him we'll be back. Back to Levin Paso. These things should avoid us, I think. Although sometimes those octopus things can't make up their mind. So, if I'd have known, I would have gone back. At the beginning of last episode, I went back and busted down two doors that McBain's special fist breaks open. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. I gotta run away anyway. We surprised the enemy. Just get rid of them. I haven't fought anything for a while. We'll split it up like this. Octi. Oh, jeez. Wow. All right, kill the Octi. Octi, Octi Island for you, whatever. Now we're getting more XP for ourselves because Altos has left the party. Ha ha. I forgot where I was going. Just the way out? Oh no, it's here. This is the cave up here. Oh, over here. Now we came in here before, there weren't any monsters, so it should be the same. Well, hopefully when we, after we talk to Viscount Eagle again, I gotta remember how to do that voice. Hopefully they'll just warp us back to Enverin, because it's annoying just walking back and forth. Dogana is south. A certain amount of milos away. That really isn't like... I don't know. It seems to be that the milos are not as accurate as the other two games. I could be wrong. But when you see something that's like... it seems like it should be close on the amount of milos, and it's far away. And the next one would be like, wow, that's really far away, and it's like right there. Mind. I do not remember where to go. Oh, it sounds familiar now. We've just never gone... I don't think we've gone this way. It's the same path as before, only in reverse. Right. It woke up and ran. It's easier when the monsters just don't want to fight you. I thought there was a dead end. I was about to cry bloody murder. Is this it? Ah, many monsters. We made it! Trying to remember where this other secret was. I didn't think I was coming back here. Probably in here? Been over there. Dun-dun-dun. I love that part. Well, what if we talk to other people in here before we talk to the Duke? Because when we talk to the Duke, we might indeed be just teleported back. The monster was exterminated, but I can't get out of the town. I'm bored. I want to pick flowers with Uto again soon. F- That monster is said to have been exterminated. I was actually concerned, so I'm relieved. By the way, who exterminated the monster? The Viscount is wounded and cannot move. Your question will have to go unanswered. I knew you exterminated the monster. I thank you on behalf of the Pensola Army. We truly appreciate your brave deed. Once the soldiers return from Riotam Island, everything will be alright. Yeah, I hope so. I'll have to read the Fred book, too. The Viscount's wound is healed pretty well. I'm sure his bruises will disappear soon. Well, let me prepare the medicine for the Viscount. I hear the Duke of Pensola and Viscount Eagle were good friends once. But that's not the case now. The Duke broke off his relationship with the Viscount and is now joining forces with Rish. I don't understand what the Duke is thinking. I just don't understand. Kids' father's in here, right? Yeah. My boy is all fine now. He forgot all about the horrible ordeal. Anyway, what is the Duke of Pensola thinking? Had he not pulled the guardsmen away from the checkpoint, the monster might not have appeared. I want our guardsmen back quickly so that they can exterminate any other monsters. Well, I just keep wanting that. If you want it enough, maybe it'll come true. Wait, is this something? Did they put the... They put this stuff here. So that you're not sure if you can get through or not. It looked like we were going... No, okay. Aha! We go a little bit in, but we can't seem to go anywhere from there. Right. Maybe we're not going in, we're just underneath the scenery. Everyone in town tries to stop me from going to the road. I want to get out of the house. Well, you can get out of the house and still stay in the town. You know that, right? How's business? Have you found that people in Enverin are picky about music? Whatever they say, just remember your musical style. Don't forget to enjoy yourself. Oh, thank you for that. By the way, the Duke of Pensola is such a heartless man. The Viscount is injured, but he doesn't even come to see him. I hate the Duke of Pensola. I'll be sure to pass that on. See you in the dungeons. It looks like the monster in the cave path was exterminated. I'm relieved. You can walk the road safely now. Yeah, I remember reading that. Yeah, he was the one who clued us in about those passages. Let's see if no unexpected guests. Seen everything besides the Viscount's house, of course. think we have. Okay. Alright, talking to the Viscount once again. That'll be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.